Title of this video, anyone that says that the mark of the beast is sin, they are effing stupid. You got these two major camps that are teaching against the MOTB. Hey, Sakaar, you need to get on these guys again. We need all the camps that believe that the MOTB is the fulfillment of Revelation chapter 13, verse 16, to let these other, like I said, maybe the leadership sold out, so they have to teach that nonsense when they know they're going to be destroyed by fire. On the day of the fulfillment of the end of the system, the Armageddon, whatever you want to call it, biblically. I understand that you sold out, you had to do what you had to do. But the people that follow these guys, the scriptures say the simple believeth every word. What does it say in Romans 16, 17, and 18? And with fair words and fine speeches, deceive the heart of the simple. So I'm watching this all over again. What is the last prophecy before the destruction? Most camps don't teach this. This is the most important prophecy other than the actual destruction. And you can say it's just as important because it's a prophecy. And the kingdom of heaven, the destruction will not come. The destruction of Esau. Esau is the end of the world. Jacob is the beginning. And their followers will not happen until this prophecy takes place. If this prophecy does not take place, neither will the destruction of Esau and the kingdom of heaven will take place. You have to be stupid to teach that. Sometimes people tell you things and in your mind, Your mind says that doesn't make any sense. That just don't make any sense. Now this is what I did. I'm not going to make this long. I put in the word. Now this guy said, matter of fact, do this. This is like the first couple of minutes. The brother in the t-shirt asked the guy from the IUIC, the mark of the beast. And the guy said, no, the mark of the beast is sin. He said, you got camps out there that tell you that it's what we say it is. But that's not true. It is sin. So, tell you that these people, what they do is they regurgitate the bullshit that they learn from their leaders. What I did was I took the word sin, right?
Yeah, this is the book of Jude, verse 24. Unto him that is able to keep you from falling, and to present you flawless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise power, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever, so be it. Giving all praises, all honor, and all glory to the Heavenly Father and his only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahasham, Yahushai Bahasham, Makra Kodash. And double honor to my teachers, the apostles, the elders, and the bishops of Great Millstone, who watch over our souls. Shalom to the Yahkin worldwide that are sincere and serious doing the will of Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushai, Bahashem Makra Kodash. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 1 and 2. To you all. Yeah, so I'm the brother, the disciple, Kosha Banyamin, from the branch in Great Millstone, Barbados, responding to the two videos. You see, we have Apostle Gabar's video here highlighted. These dudes are at ease and they put away the evil there. Talking about UIC. And Apostle Tahar's video You gotta be fucking stupid to believe that the MOTB is a sin. It's sin, right? Now, you gonna forgive me? A little bit under you better. But, you know what the scripture says, this is 1 Corinthians 14, verse 8. For if the trumpet give an uncertain sound, who shall prepare himself to the battle? Right, because in the video, Apostle Gabbard, basically, he said that these men ain't teaching the truth. They are not getting the congregation ready for what's to come. Right, the charagma of the beast, the collapse of the society, right? The great reset. He ain't getting the congregation ready. And as a shepherd, you know that the Lord has put us in a leadership position. And as in a leadership position, you can't mislead the flock. Right? You can't mislead the flock. Right? Because the Lord will hold you accountable to that. You see? This is Jeremiah 23, verse 2. Therefore, thus saith the Lord, power of Israel, against the pastors that feed my people. Ye have scattered my flock and driven them away and have not visited them. Behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doings, saith the Lord. Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai. Right? So these pastors is not telling their congregation the truth. Pastors in Israel and outside of Israel, man, because you've been put in a leadership role, and what you're doing is you're doing your work of the Lord deceitfully, right? Doing the work of the Father deceitfully, right? That's Jeremiah 48 and 10, remember, man. Jeremiah 48, let me see if I write. Jeremiah 48 and 10. Thy spirit, the word Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai. Cursed be he that doeth the work of the Lord Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai deceitfully, and cursed be he that keep it back his sword from blood. So cursed be he that do the work of the Lord deceitfully. What were you here for yourself, man? I can't remember the exact mark.
Sin pops up anytime you see it. Genesis and Jacob has so hot.
Right, so there's the brother, the Virgil Island Straight Gate. He actually played the video. So let me know you here for yourself. Where is his scriptural proof on that? He just making up things, man. Where is his scriptural proof on that? The scripture says, prove all things, man. You just lied, big man. And the man asking is true. Isn't the mark of the beast prophecy? Yes, it's prophecy. Right? First Thessalonians 5:21. Prove all things. Or fast that which is good. Right, and he didn't do that, man. He making that thing that he go along, B. You understand? And the Lord ain't dealing with that, man. You're supposed to teach the truth, man. But you see what happened is that this group here, Israel United and Cesar Borgia, right? Israel United and Cesar Borgia, right? They're putting off the evil there. You see? That's teaching you to use Israel and that's that. You understand? Now you get your mind prepared. So that way started with the scripture. Let me get it back, man. Let me get it back. Let me shut it, man. They may preparing the minds of the people, man, for what's to come. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 8. For if the trumpet, could be blown the trumpet, right? Scripture says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion and sound an alarm in my holy mountain, right? Because the enemy is about to come in. So we got to be prepared, be mentally. For if the trumpet give an uncertain sound, who shall prepare himself to the battle? Yeah, how you get yourself ready if you're blowing? If you're blowing the right trumpet, you understand? How the people gonna get themselves right? If you're feeding the lies, big man. If you're telling the lies, be right. That what the scripture says as a snare, shall it come upon all the world? Wait a minute, man. This is St. Luke 21. Let me get a 34, man. And take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life, and so that they come upon you unawares. Yeah, you're supposed to be sober-minded, man. Right? For as a snare shall it come on all them that dwell on the face of the whole earth. You see? For as a snare... So if you got false pastors feeding you lies.
Strong's G3803. Pagis.
A trick or a stratagem, temptation, snare. A snare, a trap, a noose. Of snares in which birds are entangled and caught. So when they ain't get caught, boy. Employs unexpectedly, suddenly. Because birds and beasts are caught on the rear. So when they get caught on the rears, big man. When of y'all gonna be caught on the rears because y'all listening to blind leaders, man. The apostle Tara said in his video, I would love to find out that the mark when he said it, right? But he said,
let me click on this.
He said that you should thank the Most High Yahweh, Bashem Yahushai, that he led you to great millstone, that he led you to the truth. And I do that every day, big man. You see? Because I used to follow AUIC. You see? I used to follow AUIC. You see? But for the time they said that the name of the Lord ain't matter, a question mark went in my head. You know how many name of the Lord ain't matter? So we're going to pray there. What's the strong tower? What's my strong tower? You see? Like Apostle said, when you hear the word, he said, it doesn't make sense. You see? That way the scripture says, man, playing to him. They're all playing to him. I forget where it goes, man. Not that day, not Peter. My emotion is one in sounds, man. Or they are all playing to him that understand. I can't remember where he's going, man. But they are all playing to him that understand me. So Yeah, man, the mark of the beast, the karagma of the beast is the microchip. You understand the see here? Because when you go into the root words, the root word for the word karagma, I mean for M-A-R-K is karagma, which is a cut or an incision, an imprinted mark. The root word for that word karagma is karax, which is a pale, a stake, or a palisade, which is what the needle, because that is shaping to a point. And the root word for that word karax is grapho, which is recordings. So this is going to have everything about you, know your history, you know what I mean, how much money you work for, you know what I mean, how much money in your bank account, what disease you got, etc., etc., etc. You understand? This is the way the world is heading. So it can never be sin, big man. That is not the prophecy foretold in Revelation 13 and 16, big man. If that's the case, it's all redone. Because there's no repentance for receiving that mark, big man. There's no repentance for receiving that mark. Revelation 14. It's plain as day. So if it's saying that means you waste your time preaching then. Damn fool. You ain't making any sense. If the karagma of the beast is sin, that means you waste your time teaching, because David is quick to say, man. Doom for worshippers of the beast. Revelation 14 verse 9. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image, and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. So if it's sin, that means I done. That means the Lord didn't forgive me. I gone through others. He didn't forgive you, so it made sense. You listen to the word then. Because the scripture says all have sinned and come short of the glory. So what the hell are you actually talking about, man? All have sinned and come short of the glory. But the Lord, Yahweh, sent his son, Yahweh Shai, to do what? Save his people from their sins. So what the hell could be sin? Big man. You gotta stop telling lies, man. Many false prophets are gone out into the world, man. All praises to Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai.